Hello everyone, welcome to the official Topping Pro tutorial explanation. This video introduces the E1x2 OTG audio interface. First, look at the combo input jack on the left. It supports XLR, TS, and TRS connectors. For microphones, instruments, or outboard gears with balanced output, when connecting a microphone, plug an XLR cable into the XLR input. If the microphone requires 48 volts phantom power, for example, a condenser microphone, press the 48 volts button to activate it. Then, E1x2 OTG will provide 48 volts power to the XLR input. Important note, before enabling 48 volts, check the microphone's user manual to confirm it requires 48 volts power. After enabling 48 volts, do not connect devices that are not designed to receive power to the XLR input, as this may damage them. After enabling 48 volts, do not hot plug microphones. We recommend lowering the gain first, then turning off 48 volts before unplugging microphones. 48 volts power only affects the XLR input and does not apply to the 6.35 mm jack. Thus, the 6.35 mm jacks remain unpowered regardless of 48 volt status. When connecting instruments, plug a TS cable into the 6.35 mm input jack and press the INST button to enable high impedance mode. This ensures impedance and level matching for electric guitars, bassy, etc. When connecting outboard gears with balanced output, for example, a preamp or channel strip, use a TRS cable plugged into the 6.35 mm jack. We've included a diagram to show input connections. Feel free to screenshot it. After connecting inputs, we need to adjust the input gain knob to amplify the signal from the combo jack, ensuring sufficient dynamic range and high signal-to-noise ratio. When adjusting gain, use the level meter as a guide. In1 shows input levels, and the out1-2 show output levels. The clip LED at the top indicates clipping. While speaking into the microphone or playing an instrument, monitor the in1 level meter and gradually increase the gain until the signal is strong but does not clip. For vocals, we recommend aiming for negative 12 dBFs to negative 6 dBFs. This is the power indicator. It stays on during operation, turns off when powered down, and breathes when in standby. With auto standby enabled at Topping Pro Control Center, if power is connected, but no USB, OTG or analog input signals are detected, the light will flash rapidly, entering standby after 1 minute. Once USB signals are detected, it resumes normal operation. Below is the OTG indicator, showing the connection status of the rear OTG port to mobile devices. If connected successfully, the light stays on. If unrecognized or disconnected, the light turns off. The 6.35 mm jack on the right connects to headphones. The knob above adjusts headphone volume. If max volume is insufficient, press the gain button on the left to boost the headphone output. Note, lower the volume first, then enable gain, and adjust gradually. The moan button at the top left works with the monitor mix knob on the right. First, understand monitoring. Monitoring lets you hear input signals in real time via headphones. For example, your microphone voice, to check pitch or audio quality. Monitoring can be software or hardware based. Software monitoring uses DAW or apps like OBS, introduces latency, but delivers wet signals. Hardware monitoring has zero latency. For direct routing without passing the PC, it bypasses the DAW from the microphone to your headphone. It only delivers dry signals, and you won't hear processed audio. If low latency is critical, for example, recording or fast guitar playing, press moan for hardware monitoring of real-time vocals with zero latency. After pressing the moan button, the monitor mix knob on the right side will activate. If the moan button isn't pressed, this knob remains inactive. We can use this knob to adjust the volume ratio between hardware input signals and computer signals. Turning left increases hardware input signal volume and decreases computer signal volume. At full left position, only hardware input signals will be heard. The reverse applies similarly. Important note, adjusting this knob doesn't affect input signal levels transmitted to computer. For example, during karaoke, this knob can boost vocal volume proportio without affecting recorded vocal levels in karaoke software. The prominent large knob controls monitor speaker volume. Monitor speaker ports are on the rear panel. These are 6.35 mm balanced ports, which can connect to monitors using TRS cables. Now look to the far right of the rear panel. This is the power switch, and next to it are three Type-C ports. OTG port connects mobile devices like phones or tablets. USB-C port handles data transfer and power supply. It can switch modes between PC and mobile devices. Operation method. Hold 48 volts button while powering O to enter setup mode. Level meter lighting 8 LEDs indicates PC mode. Lighting for LEDs indicates mobile mode. Short press 48 volts button to switch modes. Finally reboot after powering off. Power port provides device power, which requires DC 5 volts power supply connection, generally recommended to connect. If USB-C provides stable power, external power connection isn't needed. E1x2 OTG not only connects phones or computers for recording or live streaming or karaoke, but also simultaneously connects phones and computers to enable expanded operations. That's all for this video. If anything remains unclear, leave comments below or message us privately. See you next time.